Hey, Michael Church, Crawl Space Ninja. We got a great question from one of our viewers, and they want to know, should I install a plastic or a vapor barrier up against the subfloor? Stay tuned. If you're new to Crawl Space Ninja, we talk about encapsulation, waterproofing, even indoor air quality. We hope you'll subscribe to our channel, ring that notifications bell, follow us on Facebook, check out our DIY store, and if you're looking to start your own business, check out our franchise opportunities. A lot of manufactured homes, they install this underpinning in the home. They have a plastic or some kind of vapor barrier, and then they load it full of insulation, and then they move the home from the manufacturing site, put it on a foundation. So with manufactured homes or mobile homes, you may see an underpinning of plastic up against the subfloor, and that tends to work okay for that type of situation for a short period of time. The only problem is whenever you start to get maybe a plumbing leak, or the flange around the toilet starts to leak, that water, that moisture, that leak has nowhere to go and gets trapped by that vapor barrier, and it starts to saturate that insulation, get held up against the subfloor, and can create wood rot fungus and different things like that to where the entire subfloor starts to rot away. So if you have a standard home and you're thinking about installing a vapor barrier because you thought, hey, if I could keep that ground moisture from getting access to the subfloor, that would be a good thing. And that may be a good thing. The only problem is that you got to consider that leak from above. If you ever get that leak from above and you got some kind of plastic or even a vapor retarder on the subfloor insulation, those can trap moisture and rot out the entire subfloor. So we never install any kind of plastic on the subfloor. As a matter of fact, if we go into a crawl space and there's plastic on the floor, we try to take that out and make it to where all the subfloor and the joists can dry out with our dehumidifier so that we don't have any kind of mold issues in the future. So put the plastic on the ground, wrap the pillars, bring it up the walls, do that, but never put subfloor plastic on. We don't feel like that's a good idea. So I'm Michael Church, Crawl Space Ninja. We hope you make it a happy and blessed day, and we'll see you later.